tails wagging, all for a pawsome cause.
Just to support the RSPCA, because they do such good work, and if we get to take these guys for a walk while supporting them, I mean, it's a double win.
Yeah, I'd just rather give money to dogs in need, and they're better than humans, so...
Even the poochers who are feeling a little rough put their best paw forward.
No, he's too scared.
He loves a couch, so if there was a couch nearby, I could wheel him around, that would be lovely, but we will do our best.
Physical walks could only be held in South Australia and the Northern Territory. Changing COVID restrictions meant not every state could commit to the event when it was being planned months ago.
We know that lockdowns happen at any time, so I think every state made a decision based on their own circumstances.
For those who couldn't join the pack this morning, a virtual fundraiser is being held for the rest of this month. Dog lovers can get donations for walking at least 30 minutes a day.
Once they go to our website, they sign up and really they then head off and do their kilometres and try to walk every day and get sponsorship for that.
30,000 dogs end up at an RSPCA shelter every year. Money raised from events like this will go towards supporting the ongoing work of the organisation.
Getting all of those animals suitable for rehoming is an expensive exercise. All of that work is funded by donations, so events like Million Paws Walk are incredibly important for us.
Tiffany Warne for 10 News First.